The next clinical feature is twisted mandible movement. Here there is depressed zygomatic arch impinging on the temporal muscle or the coronary process, limiting mandible excursions. What we are able to notice here that this the fractured zygomatic arch, it causes the impingement over the temporalis muscle, which is present here, and converges onto the coronary process. And even in certain cases, this coronary process is getting impinged by the fractured zygomatic arch, this causing a limiting in mandibular excursions. Now we talk to you regarding the nasal symptoms. The nasal symptoms are ipsilateral epistaxis. Here, what is happening? This fracture of the zygomatic bone. So the floor of the orbit is fractured. The collection of blood occurs into the sinus, and from the sinus, the blood goes into the nasal cavity, and the patient presents with a bleeding nose. That is epistaxis. That is a reason for a bleeding nose. When we talk regarding the radiographic diagnosis, we need to understand that what are the best radiographs which are important to rule out a case of zygomatic fracture. So all those radiographs in which we are able to clearly see the zygomatic bone are of radiographic importance. First is the Waters view, second is the submental vertex view, and third is the Cardwell's view. Caudally angled posterior anterior radiograph of the skull designed to better visualize the paranasal sinuses. Right? The other radiographic diagnosis can be assessed by CT scan, and this image is trying to show you the presence of a fracture of the zygomatic bone. Here there is a FZ suture which is fractured. Here is the infobutal rim, and here we are able to show the zygomatic bone buttress region. When we talk of this, that is a Waters view. This X-ray is a Waters view. Even we can easily locate